I'm back with my web page about dogs, and I'm very determined to use JavaScript and the DOM API to turn it into a web page entirely about cats instead. There is an elephant in the room that I've been ignoring. Well, actually, there's a dog in the room. Two dogs, in fact. These images! I can't have images of these adorable dogs on my page about adorable cats. I need to change them. So, let's start by finding the images using get elements by tag name. Var image else equals document.get elements by tag name img. Okay. Now, since that returns multiple elements, we need to use a for loop to iterate through them. So I'll set that up. Var I equals 0, I is less than image else dot length, I plus plus. Okay, but what do I put inside the for loop? I can't change image elements with inner HTML because image tags don't have an inner HTML. They're auto closing tags. Instead, I need to change the thing about them that makes them look like dogs. The URL of the pictures. The thing that's specified with the src attribute in each of the tags. We can change attributes of elements using dot notation. Let me show you. First, we access the current element with bracket notation. And then we say dot, and we put the HTML attribute name as the JavaScript property name. SRC equals, and then we set it to some new value, and I'll just put an empty string. Notice the images went blank, since an empty string doesn't point at any image at all. To figure out what this new URL should be, I'm going to paste the old URL here and change the file name to cat, because I happen to know that that's the URL of the cat image on Khan Academy. Yay! The dogs are now cats, and our catification is mostly complete. Do you see anything else that still has to do with dogs? It's really subtle, but there is one thing left, the link to Wikipedia. It's going to the dogs page, and if the viewer follows it, they're going to catch on to my nasty trick. So I want to send them to cats instead. How should I find that link in JavaScript? I could give this link an ID and use getElementById, or I could use getElements by tag name and change all of the links on the page, or I could be really super fancy and find only links that go to pages about dogs using a CSS query selector. Let me show you the CSS query that I want to do up here in the style tag first. So this CSS query is going to find all links that have to do with dogs. First, I'm going to type A, because I'm just looking for links. Then I'm going to say brackets href star equal dog. So this tells CSS to match any link that has dog in it. And then we'll set the color to purple. Ta-da! It selected it. So that's pretty neat. And this is an attribute selector. And there's a lot of neat ways to use attribute selectors to really dig deep into your document. So now to find that in JavaScript, we can use document.querySelectorAll. So I'll say var link else equals document.querySelectorAll, and then we can just go and paste in the selector that we just made. Although we do have to make sure that we escape our double quotes. There we go. All right, so now it looks like a good string. And now I need to iterate through these. So once again, we just do our for loop and should be getting really used to doing these for loops. I plus plus. And for each of them, I want to change the link to the web page about cats on Wikipedia. So I'm gonna say link else I dot href, because that's the name of the attribute that we're changing. And then equals, and I'll go find this URL and paste it down here and just change it to cat. because I'm pretty sure that's the URL of that page. Ta-da! World Catenation is complete. But you are not done learning how to manipulate web pages in JavaScript, so stick around.